cold. Super cold.
This is like a rolling.
That'll be brilliant.
Hey guys, welcome to Candid Combos. We're back this week with our episode on the Women's March.
Woo!
Hey!
So much fun.
Yes, so we did get to attend the Women's March in Washington, D.C., and it was definitely one of the most amazing experiences that we've ever had. And luckily, we're able to take along our daughters, yes. Mom, nieces, family, friend. Like, it was all good. It was all love. So it's a great time.
And all women, so it's great that, you know.
Yeah, this was our first girls' trip with our daughters, and I'm glad that it was such an amazing experience for them to see women of all different races and ethnicities together.
Yes, and for those who don't know, the Women's March is actually a movement that was formed once Trump hit office.
Yeah,
I'm not even gonna give him that privilege.
Take that title away.
Yeah. Once he went into office and people were outraged, rightfully so, the Women's March did begin in 2017. So it's just an annual event that happens in different cities around the world.
Yeah, major cities. D.C., Houston.
New Orleans.
Yeah.
Or you could host a march in your city. You could just be a representative. I was looking into that.
Okay.
If
rep.
We is,
city
you
know, rep?
Yeah. If we ever wanted to.
So our reason for going was the fact that we're hosting a womanhood season right now. So we thought it was only fitting, perfect timing. So that's kind of the reason why we went, as well as to show our support, to learn more, to meet people out there, and to teach, you know, our little ones the importance of standing up for themselves and what they believe in.
Yeah, that was probably definitely one of my...
One of your, what, maybe proudest, like, teachable moments?
Definitely. Definitely wanted to show my daughter that women uniting together is a force to be reckoned with. And I think she saw that.
Yeah, and I think it was also good to show them women advocating for what they believe in, you know? And once we unite together...
Magic can happen.
Magic happens.
Yeah. Yes. So now we're going to go into some of our interviews. Like I said, we were able to interview some amazing women out there. So enjoy, guys. I just want to say it's so good to see another group of beautiful black women out here supporting women. We came all the way from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Right. Okay. So what made you guys come out today?
Because I'm a black woman. I'm here to support a black woman especially. Right.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. I'm a woman. I support all women, equality among all genders.
Yes.
Support women, for sure.
And what's your stance on this administration and what we're going through right now?
This government shutdown is ridiculous.
It is.
And, you know, it just proves that when you leave voting rights and you leave the government in the wrong hands, this is where we end up.
Mm-hmm.
They were mad about Obama, and now we're here.
Yeah.
This is just retaliation. That's all it is. But we're going to get through it as usual because God takes care.
Yes.
God blesses.
Yes.
And, you know, we are here.
Yes.
Period.
Yes.
And
what's your ultimate goal with coming here? What are you hoping to accomplish?
I hope to be heard at the most. We all made posters. We all woke up at 7 on a Saturday morning.
Yes.
And we just want to be heard. We women, and we just want... I don't want my daughter to have to march for the same thing.
We don't want to keep marching. Yeah, we want to bring forth change for all women.
Yes. Create more unity, too, like among us.
Like-minded people. It's really great to come out here and see people with similar values and stuff like that. So we get to meet and, like, think of ideas on how to change, really.
Definitely. Well, thank you, ladies.
My name is Jennifer. I'm actually here representing all of our county as much as we can. We have a good number here already, but we want to make sure that people know that there are Democrats in Cecil County, firstly.
Yes.
Very important. That we're growing in number and we're growing in voice. We're unifying and we're mobilizing, which is even more important.
Oh, nice.
And we want to make sure that people understand that unity means of all parties, of all races, of all genders, of all identities. There should be never a wall. There should never be a censor of any sort.
Yes.
And it's really what we're here for is just empowerment, because if not, this administration is just squelching everything we stand for in this country. We need that to just stop. It's not, we're not moving forward clearly. We're not just in a shutdown. We are in a halt.
Yes.
So anything that we could do to make a change and make it go forward, that's what we're looking for.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. So we came out here and we were just curious to see why you guys, this is your third year, so why are you back? What does this mean for you to be out here at the Women's March?
It's empowering. I mean, it gives us hope.
Yeah.
Hope.
Yes, I agree.
Things will change. Things will get better.
Yes, because change can happen.
I believe it. I believe it. It's just the only thing keeping me going.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
All right, can I get y'all's names and how you spell them?
Tiana.
Okay, can you spell it for me? Okay, and your name?
True, T-R-U.
All right, so you guys are from South Florida. Are you excited to be here today?
Yeah.
All right. Why are girls so important?
Because they rule the world.
They're beautiful and they rule the world. I like that. What do you like?
J-E-N-S-E-N.
Okay. There's a girl at my school named Chloe.
Okay. And where are you guys from? Memphis?
We're from Nashville.
Oh, okay. Nice. Mm-hmm. And what are you doing out here?
So I'm actually making a student documentary. I'm a junior in high school, and I get to submit this documentary to a festival.
Oh.
Fingers crossed it gets nominated.
Yes.
We're
going to manifest it's going to get nominated.
It's something I've been passionate about for such a long time. Over the summer, I actually had the opportunity to intern for somebody running for House of Representatives, Justin Canoe. And that just really sparked something in me. Politics is really important. And this time, and it's just watching this, we're all the future.
Yes.
We're all the future, and we all have the ability to make a change. So being at places like this gives you more of that power to make that change and have your voice heard.
Definitely. And what would you say has been the most rewarding part about this whole day for you?
I think seeing all of the diversity, like coming from a suburban city in Tennessee, like it's very, very like white, so seeing all of the people, seeing all the like indigenous people, black people, Muslim people, I think that's the most rewarding thing, because you see that we're kind of all like in this together, and it's not just like one group, it's everyone working together.
We're all unified.
Yeah.
We're all here to have a voice heard.
That's awesome. And lastly, go ahead.
I just want to know, how are you guys connected?
We're just best friends.
We're best friends.
Awesome.
Yes.
Love that.
Yes.
Okay, so why was it important for you guys to come to the Women's March?
This year we are part of the first inaugural group of students to ever be able to go to Notre Dame, or come to the Women's March in D.C. We're obviously known for a school that's very conservative, and they send about 1,000 kids a year to the March for Life.
Okay.
And so this year we have 50 kids here representing us.
Like 600 wanted to come, so we're hoping that in the future it can become like a big movement at our school.
Awesome.
Needs a lot of changes. So.
Yeah.
We're fighting for strong women. We are strong women. We have strong women and men here with us today, and we hope to kind of encourage the next generations and generations to come for some change. So
awesome. Yeah. Thank you guys.
Thank you ladies.
And I'm the president of the Metro Washington D.C. Bennett College Alumni Chapter.
Okay, nice. And is this your first time here?
This is my first time here, yes.
We
came down here today because our institution, Bennett College, is in jeopardy of closure due to financial instability.
Oh.
We have until February 1st to raise $5 million to prove to the accrediting agency that we have enough finances to stay open. So we just came down here today because it's a bunch of women. It's a woman's HBCU.
Yes.
One of two in the country.
Yeah.
So we're here to ask people to stand with Bennett. Make a donation via Cash App, Stand with Bennett, or go to our website, bennett.edu/standwithbennett, and just, you know, support the cause. We can't get rid of another institution for black women.
Yes.
So
we need it.
So thank you guys.
You know, but sometimes you ask yourself, where's the peace? Everybody always talking about peace, but as long as you find peace in what you're doing, then you're successful. And that's what people don't realize. So you got to do stuff to where you can go to sleep at night. Because the glory is in you.
In the whole wide world, all my niggas in the whole wide world made the song to make it all yours. Time for us, this shit is for us. All my niggas let the whole world know, play the song and sing it on your terms. For us, this shit is for us. Don't try to come for us. All my niggas got the whole wide world. Tell them niggas that it's all our time. This us, some shit is for us. Some shit is for us. When you know you gotta pay the cost, play the game just to play the boss. So you're thinking what you gain, get lost. But you know your shit is taking off. Oh, when you're driving in your tinted car, and you're criminal just who you are. But you know you're gonna make it fun. Oh, when you're feeling all alone, and you can't even be you up in your home. When you even feeling it from your own, when you gotta figure it out. When a nigga tryna board the plane, and they ask you what's your name again.
Hey guys, welcome back to Candid Combos. As you can see, I have some new guests with me today. Why don't we go ahead and introduce ourselves?
Hi, my name is Chu, and I'm 5 years old.
Hi, my name is Tiana, and I'm 8 years old.
So as you guys may know already, or maybe you don't know, these are Jasmine and Raven's daughters. Jasmine's daughter, Raven's daughter. Unfortunately, Jasmine and Raven couldn't be here today. So instead, we have Sienna and Chu to help us out with this episode. You guys both went to the Women's March. So Sienna, let me ask you, what did you think about the Women's March?
It's like going to the Women's March is like a new experience for a little girl to know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And how so? How was it a new experience? What was new for you?
Seeing like other girls, seeing other people being there, supporting other women because they can rule the world and people know that girls are important.
Nice. And Drew, what did you think about the Women's March?
Well, it was a little too crowded, but I was much happy.
Much happy.
To be with my friends and family together.
Okay.
To make new friends.
So what would you say, Drew, was your favorite part of the whole Women's March? Do you have a favorite?
Yeah, but my favorite was mostly spending time with my family.
Okay, that's awesome. And Nana, you have a favorite part?
Yes. When we was doing that report about like how girls are important, yeah, that's my favorite part.
Yeah, that was awesome. Okay, and last question. If you guys were going to go back to the Women's March, maybe next year, and maybe you have a friend that's curious about going to the Women's March, what advice would you give your friends about the Women's March?
Telling them that other people can stand up for other people.
Okay, I like that. Other people can stand up for other people. So you don't have to just stand up for yourself or people like you. You can be a man and still stand up for women, right?
I saw some men at the there supporting women too.
So. Okay, nice. And True, what advice would you give your friends?
I would tell them not to be scared, because if they be scared, they don't know what to do.
Yeah, so like to be brave. Like your shirt says brave and kind. Look at that. So to be brave, and you know, it's okay if it's your first time going. Maybe get together with some friends and go out there and have a lot of fun. Yeah?
Mine says kind and strong.
Kind and strong and brave and kind. Look at that.
So mighty power.
Mighty power. So, kind. So, why don't you guys send them off to watch the video?
Yeah, check it out. Yeah. It's very cool. I like it.
Okay.
Well, guys, make sure you give a good thumbs up to it.
A good thumbs
up. And subscribe down below.
To our channel.
And follow Candid Combos.
Thanks, guys.
Candid Combos are the best. Give four thumbs up.
I actually like that. That was fun.
Thank you. We're all done. So let's listen to it. That was perfect.